Hello, everybody, and welcome back to PE. We're going to continue with our muscle names, where they are, and our stretches. So today we're going to work on stretching our lower body. Okay, so we're going to do three stretches today. We're going to work on our hip flexors, which are obviously in our hips. Okay, we're going to work on our hamstrings, which are the backs of our legs. Okay, and we're going to work on our IT bands, which is our side. So kind of from our hips down our side, okay, almost toward you, but not quite. Okay, so first one we're going to do first is our hip flexors. Again, they're right here. They're tendons, ligaments in your muscles that can get really, really tight, okay, especially when we're sitting a lot. Okay, if you think of it, your body like a chair kind of too, you need to stretch those muscles out, or like a rubber band. So if a rubber band is brand new, it's really tight, it's really hard to pull apart, okay? And if you pull it too hard, it will snap, okay? So you want to slowly stretch it out, okay? The more you stretch it, the looser it gets. So kind of same thing with your muscles, your ligaments, and your tendons, okay? So we're going to do hip flexors first. There's two ways we can do hip flexors. I'm going to show you them first, and then you can decide which one you want when we start counting. So first way you can do it standing. I'm going to start by having feet together, then I'm going to take one foot and step up, kind of a big step, okay, but not so far that you're off balance. You still want to be center, okay? Both toes are still pointing forward, okay? You don't twist the back foot. If you do that, you're not going to get a stretch, okay? So both toes still pointing forward, okay? Hips still pointing forward, okay? You don't want to twist your hips to the side either. You want them facing the same way as your toes, okay? And all I'm going to do is I'm going to keep my shoulders back and my hips forward, and I'm going to bend both knees forward. Okay, I'm pretty sure we did this in our first week lessons too, but we're doing them again because those are big important ones you want to stretch. Okay, and again, you should feel that stretch from your hips down the front of your leg. Okay, if you don't like the standing one, you feel like you're not feeling anything, what you can do is same thing from this position. You can drop down to one knee, okay, and put your toe flat. Okay, again, this leg's still up. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take both hands, put them on top of my knee, and I'm going to, same thing, keep my shoulders back and push my hips and knee forward, okay, until I feel that stretch. So again, you should feel it right here, okay? I'm going to do this one kneeling because I feel like it gives me a better stretch, but you pick which one you like better, okay? Give you a second to get in ready position for your stretches. Remember, we're doing these for 20 seconds each leg, okay? Ready and begin. So we're going to have 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. And let's do the other leg. Okay, same thing, switch it around. Other knee up, hands on my knee. And begin. Remember, lean, shoulders back, hips forward, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Okay, and those were our hip flexors. Okay, next one we're gonna do is our hamstrings. Okay, remember those are the muscles right here on the backs of our legs. Okay, and there's a couple different ways you can do hamstring stretches as well, so I'll show you them. So one, you can have feet together. Okay, if you think you're really flexible and you want feet together, keeping those knees straight, you're gonna hang down as far as you can. See if you can touch your toes, keeping these knees straight, don't bend them, okay? Or you can put your feet about shoulder width apart. Okay, not too far. If you go too far apart, you're not gonna get a good stretch. Okay, so you want them about shoulder width apart. Same thing, keep your knees straight, hang down as far as you can. Okay, if you can only go as far as your knees, that's fine. Okay, wherever there's a comfortable stretch. You don't want to try to overdo it or hurt yourself by going farther than you're comfortable with. Okay, so again, you can hang, go as far as you can, keeping those knees straight. Okay, or you can sit. Okay, same thing though, feet apart and reach towards the middle. Okay, or you can keep your feet together, toes up, and reach towards your toes. But if you sit, same thing, your knees always stay straight. Anytime you bend your knees, you're not gonna get that stretch, okay? And my dog Scout saying hi, she thinks when I sit on the ground, it means it's her turn for attention. Okay, hey, go lay down. Okay, so I'm gonna do them sitting. I'm gonna reach for my toes, okay? So ready, you're ready to position, and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good. Okay. Last but not least, we're gonna do our IT band. So again, you can do these ones sitting or standing. Okay. The way we stretch our IT bands is a figure four stretch. Okay. So what that means is I'll show you sitting and then I'll show you standing. I'm gonna take one leg, I'm gonna take my ankle and put it on my knee or just a little bit above. Okay, so I kind of look like a four. Okay, I'm gonna put my hands behind my back, okay, to brace myself, and at the same time, I'm gonna bend that straight leg so my foot's flat. Okay, now from here, I'm gonna push my chest in towards my foot, okay, just like so. If you need to bring this foot in a little closer to get a good stretch, you can do that as well. Okay, but one thing you do not wanna do is lift your bottom off the ground, okay, because again, now you're not getting a stretch, okay? Just like so. If that one's not working for you, you can try it standing. So how you would do it standing is the same way. If you wanna find a wall or grab a chair or something to help balance you, again, you're gonna take one foot, place it above your knee, so on a four. Okay, and if you do it standing, this leg you're standing on now is gonna bend as far as you can, lose your balance, and you're gonna take your other hand and push down on that end part of the four. So that knee that looks like that four, you're gonna push down. Okay, so again, pick which one's your favorite. We're gonna do it for 20 seconds. Okay, so I'm gonna do it standing, and here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good, and let's do the other side. Okay, this one's gonna be a little bit trickier for me since I don't have a wall to bounce on, but we can do it. Okay, so I got my four, okay, I'm bending that knee, pushing down, and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Good, so you should have felt that one down your side, okay? So again, we learned three new ones. In our hips, we have hip flexors, okay? Down our sides, we have our IT band. In the back of our leg, there are our hamstrings, okay? Great job today, that's all we have for today's. Tomorrow, we will have three new body parts and muscles to learn and stretch, and I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.